Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today we're talking about translating with inequalities. When you have a symbol that's pointing to the right, that is the greater than symbol. And when you have the arrow that's pointing to the left, that is the is less than symbol. If you have a greater than equal to, you'll see it's the same symbol as the greater than with a little line under it, equal to part. Less than equal to is similar with the equal to part in there. When I'm asking you to translate x is at least 17, that's a little tricky. Is at least sounds like less than, right? But think about to get into an R-rated movie, the student has to be at least 17. So if you were saying the person has to be at least 17 to get in, they could be exactly 17, equal to, or they could be more than or greater than 17. So is at least actually means greater than or equal to. Now number two, Y is at most negative 12. So if you have something that's at most negative 12, that means it could be exactly negative 12, the equal to part. But it could also be anything less than that. At most means that's the biggest thing it could possibly be, or the greatest thing that it could possibly be. Okay, something like this where we want to write a statement using an inequality. The boiling point in Celsius is 100 degrees. In Fahrenheit, it is 212 degrees. Compare the quantities using greater than or less than symbols. Well, Celsius boiling point is 100 and Fahrenheit is 212. Just strictly speaking about the numbers and not their actual temperature, because they both are where the point where water boils. 100 is less than 212, so we point to the smaller number. If we had asking you to compare and we were using something like this, we have, my paper got crinkled. We have two angles. We say compare angle A. This little symbol is not a greater than not a less than symbol. It kind of looks like it, but it actually comes down and then it runs flat along the bottom line. So it's a little different than a less than symbol. That's an angle. Angle A to angle B. Well, angle A is 23. Degrees and angle B is 17 degrees. So when you're thinking about those two numbers, which number is greater? 23 is greater, so we point to the little guy. Now number 5 says use an inequality to compare 5 to 5. Well, it says an inequality. I know that they're equal, but I could say it's equal to or less than, or I could say it's greater than or equal to. Those are both true, so either one of those could be possible. All right, rewrite negative 15 is less than or equal to 7 using a different symbol. Well, we want to use a different inequality symbol, I should say. So I'm going to rewrite this. I'm going to rearrange this, make this 7 and make this negative 15. If I want to rewrite it, I could change the order of it, but I don't want to change the value. In other words, 7 is still the greater number. You see how we're pointing at negative 15 here? That's because it's the lesser number. So we want to point at the lesser number, so I could flip it around, and if I do, I still want to make sure that the opening is to the larger number and the arrow points to the small guy, right? All right. Using S as a variable, translate, the student must be at least 15. Here's my variable S, and here's the number that I'm comparing. What do you want to do for is at least? Do you remember from earlier in the video? If they have to be at least 15, they could be exactly 15 or greater than 15. Okay, so at least means greater than or equal to. And I put that one in there again because it's tricky. You have to remember it. And finally, translate, 17 is not equal to negative 3. Well, if it's not equal to, then we could say it's less than or it's greater than. We can also use, this is not an inequality symbol, but we could say 17 is not equal to. Okay, so that's another way to say that. We can also use that symbol. Okay, I hope you have a fantastic day, and we'll see you next time. If I can figure out how to close my video, I'm trying to caption this while I do it, so it's taking me a little time to figure that out. All right, have a fantastic day.